Edvotek Instructional Videos presents Exploring Biotechnology with the Green Fluorescent Protein, Module 4, Analysis of GFP by SDS Gel Electrophoresis. In Module 4, GFP fractions from Module 3 will be analyzed using SDS-PAGE. Native samples will be mixed with glycerol, while denatured samples will be mixed with a denaturing solution and boiled. Both samples will then be run on an SDS-PAGE gel and analyzed. For this module, you will need tubes containing purified GFP from Module 3, tubes of 50% glycerol and protein denaturing solution, rehydrated standard protein marker, a vertical electrophoresis apparatus and power supply, a micropipette and tips, an SDS-PAGE gel to be shared between groups, diluted electrophoresis buffer, protein staining and destaining solution, and finally, a protein instastain card. Preparing native protein or unboiled sample. Step 1. Add 10 microliters of 50% glycerol to the tube labeled GFP native. Step 2. Mix and set the tube aside for electrophoresis. Preparing denatured proteins or boiled. Step 3. To denature the protein sample, add 10 microliters of protein denaturing solution to the tube labeled GFP denatured and mix well. Step 4. Bring a beaker of water covered with aluminum foil to a boil on a hot plate. Step 5. Push the bottom of the GFP sample tube to be denatured through the foil and immerse in the boiling water. The tube should be kept suspended by the foil. Step 6. Boil the GFP sample for 5 minutes. Step 7. Remove the sample tube from the beaker and allow it to cool for a few minutes at room temperature. Preparing PAGE gel and chamber. Step 1. Open the pouch containing the gel cassette. Remove the cassette and place it on the bench with the shorter front plate facing up. Step 2. Some gels may feature a sticker or tape at the bottom of the front plate. Remove the tape if present to expose the bottom of the gel. Step 3. Carefully remove the comb by gently pulling upwards. Pull the comb straight up to prevent damage to the wells of the gel. Step 4. Insert the gel into the electrophoresis chamber. Orient the gel according to the manufacturer's instructions. For Edvotek vertical electrophoresis chambers, the short plate should face the interior. Step 5. Add diluted electrophoresis buffer to the chamber until it covers the top of the shorter front plate. Step 6. Rinse each well by carefully squirting electrophoresis buffer into the wells using a transfer pipette. The gel is now ready for sample loading. Loading the protein samples. Step 1. Using a fine micropipette tip, measure 20 microliters of the first sample or standard protein marker. Step 2. Place the pipette tip under the buffer and directly above the sample well, resting gently against the back plate of the gel cassette. Step 3. Slowly dispense the sample by depressing the plunger. Step 4. Repeat steps 1 through 3 for the remaining samples, changing the tip between each new sample. Step 5. Once all samples have been loaded, carefully place the cover onto the electrode terminals. Step 6. Connect the electrical leads to the power supply. Step 7. Set the voltage of the power supply and perform electrophoresis. Allow the proteins to separate through the gel for the recommended length of time or until the tracking dye reaches near the bottom of the gel. Step 8. After the electrophoresis is finished, turn off the power supply, disconnect the leads, and carefully remove the cover. The gel can now be removed from the chamber. Staining the gel. Step 1. After electrophoresis, lay the cassette down and remove the front plate by placing a thin spatula or screwdriver at the side edge and gently lift it away from the larger back plate. In most cases, the gel will stay on the back plate. If it partially pulls away from the front plate, let it fall onto the back plate. Handle the gel carefully, as it is very thin and extremely fragile. Step 2. transfer the gel on the back plate to a clean tray. Step 3. Add approximately 100 ml of the staining-destaining solution to the tray containing the gel and back plate. Use enough solution to just cover the gel. Step 4. Carefully remove the back plate from the tray, leaving just the gel in the staining solution. Step 5. Gently float a sheet of protein instastain with the stain side down in the staining destaining solution. Step 6. Allow the protein instastain paper to stain the gel for about 1 hour at room temperature with gentle, occasional, or continuous agitation. Step 7. Remove the paper after an hour and allow the gel to gently agitate on a rocking platform or just on the lab bench for 1 to 3 hours or overnight. Cover if incubating overnight. Step 8. After staining, protein bands will appear medium to dark blue against a light background. For more information on this or any other Edvotek products, please visit www.edvotek.com. That's www.edvotek.com.